Hello and welcome to Wolf Ridge and the North Shore. My name is Caroline and I'll be your naturalist today while we explore energy in your home. Can't see a lot from the desk here, so let's head on outside. Did you know that living and working in buildings is the largest percent of energy use in the United States? That's a pretty big deal. So today we're going to explore energy in your home. But what even is energy? Energy is the ability to do work. Speaking of homes, I have a friend who has a really awesome home. Maybe I'll call him and see if I can come over. Oh, Robbie, hi, how are you doing? I'm doing great too. Hey, do you mind if I come over? Really, you are? Well, can I just come anyway? Sweet, I'll be there in 30 seconds. Oh, he's letting me come over, awesome. I'm gonna bring him this wattometer. He can plug in appliances to it and see how much energy they're using. Let's go!
Wow, I did not realize how loud everything was.
I can actually hear myself think now. Robbie, you had a lot of things turned on and plugged in that you weren't even using.
Yeah.
You should think more about what you have turned on when you're using it and try to limit how much power you're using. Here, I got you this kilowatt reader. You can plug it into your outlet and then plug in electronics into it. And then on the screen, it tells you how much power they're using.
All right, let's check it out.
Sweet, let's go. So this is a kilowatt meter, and what it does is it measures the instantaneous power that an appliance is using. So to use it, we're gonna plug it into an outlet. We're gonna hit the watt button so that we're measuring in watts. And a watt is just power that's being used in that moment. Here you have a nice LED light bulb. Plug it in, ooh, it turns on, wow. And right now it's measuring about 9 watts. This is a really nice LED light bulb, but you also have an incandescent. So let's see what that one looks like. I can feel more heat coming out of this one. It's reading about 41.3. Wow, that's a lot more. Cool thing about appliances, you have choices about what you want to use.
Okay, I'm curious to see how much power my hair dryer, which I use every day, uses. Let's plug it in. Now it's got two functions. It's got a low setting and a high setting. We'll start with low. up to 700 watts. Now we'll do the high setting. 1500 watts.
Energy can be used to make lots of different things, Robbie, like light, sound, and heat, but heat is the one that uses the most energy. That's why your hair dryer was at 1500 watts. And remember back to the light bulbs, the difference between the two of them, 9 watts for the LED and 40 for the incandescent, it's because the incandescent makes more heat. Hey Robbie, how much energy is the Wii using?
Let's see, about 16 or 17 watts. It's less than my hair dryer.
That's right, it is. But I bet you keep your Wii plugged in even when you're not using it.
Mm-hmm, totally.
Try turning it off.
Won't it just go to 0 watts if I turn it off?
Let's find out.
Oh, weird, it's still got like 1.5 watts.
Yeah, I figured that would happen. It's called ghost power, or sometimes even vampire energy. And that's when your appliances still use energy even when they're not turned on.
So if I leave this plugged in for months at a time like I do, it's sucking energy even when I'm not using it?
Yeah, that's right. A really easy way to save energy is just to simply unplug your appliances when you're not using them.
Okay, Carol, so I understand now that all of these appliances and things that I use and love use a lot of energy and power, but what's the big deal?
It's a good question. And it's really hard when you're in your house, you know, using electronics. Sometimes you lose the sight of the big picture. But one thing that really hits home for a lot of people is the money that you save when you save electricity. When you plug things in, then you're going to have to pay for it.
Why else should I care about conserving energy?
Another reason is for saving resources. Whenever we use energy, something has to be given in to make that energy. They aren't unlimited and could run out someday if we aren't careful. Here at Wolf Ridge, we use a specialized pellet stove that burns pellets from recycled wooden materials. The stove burns so efficiently, there usually isn't any smoke. We're reducing our use of resources by using recycled materials, but we still have to remember that we're using a resource that will only last if we harvest trees responsibly. Imagine what could happen to the trees around Wolf Ridge if we weren't trying to be responsible with our heat usage. Gases like carbon dioxide, methane, and water vapor are naturally occurring in our atmosphere. However, with our current use of energy, in our homes, cars, airplanes, factories, and more, we are increasing the amount of these gases to levels that our Earth cannot sustain. The presence of these gases in the atmosphere cause the greenhouse effect. Energy in the form of sunlight reaches the Earth, and some of it is reflected back into space. Some is absorbed and re-radiated, but most is absorbed by greenhouse gases in our atmosphere. Some greenhouse effect is a good thing. Without it, our planet would be freezing cold like Mars. But as we produce more and more of these gases, the greenhouse effect increases and leads to rapid warming of our planet. As our Earth's temperature rises, it causes things including warming oceans, increasing sea levels, glaciers melting, and changing weather patterns. Here are some things you can do in your home to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. Turning off the lights when you're not using them. Recycling. Unplugging things when you aren't using them or when it's fully charged. And take one less shower a week.
Along with individual actions, you can also have a big impact on how your community responds to climate change. Students across Minnesota and the United States are taking action to ensure that humans and our planet have a healthy future. In the town of Grand Marais on the North Shore, students ages 9 to 16 spoke in front of the city council asking the city to develop a plan for how they would reduce their energy use. As a result, the city passed a climate action plan that is now being put into place. Here is 11-year-old Alia Wright reading the plan. Wow, that was awesome hearing about how young people are affecting change in their community. And we hope that that's something that you all can do as well. In fact, this year for me personally, I started tracking all the miles that I drive in my car. I've got a Google spreadsheet and every week I can jot down the information there.
Yeah, that's awesome, Robbie. One thing I've been trying to focus on is turning lights off when no one's in the room. It's so annoying to me when people leave the kitchen, but they leave the light on. Ugh. All these changes seem really small and like you're not really making a difference, but if you record them in your nature journal, you can keep track of the impact you're making. And if all of us work together and make little changes, that'll really add up. In your nature journal, you can record how many times you unplug things, where you notice energy being used, and choices you make. Maybe you choose to use an energy-efficient appliance. You can also make a list of your needs versus wants so you can prioritize where you use your energy.
Oh, Carol, do you feel the sun?
Yes.
It burns.
Oh, wow.
And all that energy from the sun's hitting our solar panels and making clean energy for us.
I also kind of feel like as it's hitting me, it's generating energy in my own body.
Yeah, you look like you've been at the desk for a little too long.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, we should get out of here, and we'll see all of you next week for Watersheds to find out how all the water in this region flows into Lake Superior.
Do you think the sun will be in that episode too?
I sure hope so.
Oh, wow.
See you later. Make sure you grab your rubber boots for a little creek stomping as you discover your own watershed address. Ooh, look, an agate.
Plugging it.
Okay, won't it go to zero? For a little bit of creek stomping as you discover your own watershed address. Oh, look, an agate.